My dear crafty friends, I am back with another art journal page, again a little bit grungy, and for this page I also used some of my designs, so please stay tuned and check it out. This time I'm starting with focal points. So I designed two books with my original hand-drawn designs, and for this challenge, or for this project, it's actually a challenge on Lindy's blog for the month of June, I'm using these pots because coincidentally they are the same color as it's asked of us to do for the Lindy's challenge. So when I've seen the board, I said to myself that I have to do them, and they are one of the favorite of mine. At the end of this movie, there is a small flip through, like 40 seconds long, through my books. So if you want to stay tuned and wait and have a look, maybe you'll find something which will interest you. Coming back to my project, I'm using my art journal with the watercolor paper. I spray the colors, and this is the challenge color board for Lindy's for this month. I said I spray the colors. I actually sprayed the water on the paper, and now I'm spraying the colors. Urban Amethyst, this one is flat Fabio, so it doesn't have a shine, and the other is French Lilac Violet, and this one has a shine. And I am mentioning quite often that I have a problem with color application, because every time I want to do something different and I kind of don't, you know, I'm just thinking, or maybe overthinking, you know, how to apply the colors, and every time I'm trying really to do something different, so I just don't put them in one place, in the middle or on the side, you know. This time I, as you've seen, I add some water, and then I did splatters, very irregular splatters with the nozzle from the bottle. No, it's not the nozzle, it's the long pipe from the bottle, and I'm drying it. But while drying, I said to myself that I want to have the, you know, borders, the stains with borders. And the idea or ideal way to do it is to actually, while drying, add splatters of water, or just even, you know, add water with the brush. Because those are colors based on water, when you add water, they will react with it, they will run on the paper, and then you of course can direct it with the heat gun, so you can make these beautiful, beautiful stains. I'm adding now a little bit of scintillating silver. It's a glitzy magical, and I have no idea why I don't use them often. They are giving you beautiful, beautiful shine, and maybe that's why I'm not very shiny person if it comes to art I'm creating, but they are absolutely lovely. And as you can see here, I got this beautiful splatter, and it looks so nice with this color. I find that it's so beautiful. And for Lindy's challenge, if you ever wonder, you can of course always add white, blacks, and metallic colors. So this one, my those are my pots, which I'm gonna place on the paper. And before I do that, I actually use calligraphy pen to cover, you know, the sides when you have tiny bit of white space visible, because I didn't fuzzy cut them as perfectly as I could. So that's why I'm using calligraphy pen. You of course can use an ink pad, but I find that calligraphy pen, because the nib is flat, it works perfectly on it, on the fuzzy cutting, fuzzy cut elements like that. And then, of course, I'm adding my splatters. No, not splatters, my stamping. I think it's very late. I've been working hard today, all day long, and I'm getting a tongue twist here. But I'm adding my stamping now. The red stamps I'm using, they are from Viva Las Vegas stamps, and they are designed by DeeDee, Catron, and I absolutely love them. And this one is in the shape of rectangles. And after I actually add the smaller rectangles, I got the idea that it looks a little bit like a, maybe not a city skyline, but some kind of a skyline. I wanted to go a little bit further with it, make it a little bit messy, and make these pots not really as the flowers, as it was my first idea, but kind of as a gigantic, enormous flowers in an apocalyptic world a little. I'm showing you I'm dirty. Always dirty, you know, when I'm working on my projects. And I'm really ashamed to, you know, to continue and to show you on the videos, but, you know, it's like that. I wait until I finish, then I wash my hands. That way I'm a messy crafter. So coming back to my apocalyptic world. When I drawn the flowers, I actually imagined them in a very, you know, fairyland. Like really something super nice and super cool and super sweet. And that's the thing also, you know, we can interpret things in so many ways, and at the end, you know, we can completely change our view of the things. And when I've seen this, you know, kind of a horizontal line when so many things are happening, which looks a little like a skyline, you know, of the world, which is kind of in ruins almost, with the background, which is a little bit kind of like worrying, I think. I decided that the pots will look very nice as a, you know, on the foreground, with the notion in my head that they are huge and that, you know, that's what is left, you know, in the nature. And even though it's a sad vision, I find it it's still optimistic. And of course you are open to your own interpretation. I like to read your comments, because sometimes, you know, you are saying to me, have you seen this one? And I see it, something else completely in your project, and I absolutely love it. And now I'm inking the edges with the Stazon Archival ink. And I find it that if you use a lot of black on your projects and you have some negative space, it's very nice to frame it either by doing what I've just done, or even drawing a kind of a frame around it. It gives, you know, the connection between the focal point and what's happening around it and the edges. So that's what I'm doing. Now I'm adhering my flowers, so I'm using Nuvo Deluxe Adhesive. And I am also adding an extra layer to the flower. And I'm not doing that because the flower is not sturdy enough. It is sturdy, it's just I wanted to make it pop a little out from the background. And I didn't want to use the 3D foam tape because it's simply too thick. So that's why I use another piece of paper. And for this one I also use only glue. And there is this part on the left which annoys me, because I feel that the paint is applied like as a straight line, so I'm adding a little bit now here. Sometimes things like that, you know, you just see at the very end, and if you can fix it, that's perfect. If you cannot, well, you have to live with what you've done. And I'm trying to still, you know, work and make these small stains. I think, if I remember correctly, since I'm doing voiceover, yes, the last thing it's adding a little bit of my super messy words, not a little bit, a sentence. And that would be it for this project. As always, you're gonna get the links to all the products, or all the products listed, in the description box below, and there is also a link to my shop. I would appreciate really so much if you have a look. And if you have any comments, I am very, very happy to hear them. I wish you a beautiful day. Please don't forget to subscribe. I'm waiting for all your comments. And I'm sending you big, big hugs. And see you in the next movie. Bye. We'll be right back. Thank you.